Hello everyone. This tutorial number 3 is all about part modeling in ANSYS Workbench Design Modeler. In the last two tutorial, we have learned that how to create solid part, and in this tutorial we are going to learn how to create line bodies and surface body. So here learning in the video is understand line bodies and cross sections available in Design Modeler. Then create line bodies from the sketches. Apply cross sections to the line bodies. There are number of cross sections available in Design Modeler. Then we have to assign these cross sections to the line bodies. Then create surface bodies from the sketches. Then how to create whole feature by using pattern tool is explained in the video. Then how to split the surfaces. So these are the learning in the videos. So start with our first problem. So first problem is all about create C cross section line body for the beam. So here all the dimensions of C cross section is given, that is width is 30, height is 50, and thickness of the C is 4 mm, and you can see the C cross section here. Then length of the line is 100 mm. So let's begin with this problem number 1. So open ANSYS Workbench. Here I have already created the geometry component system in project schematic. Then open Design Modeler by right click on geometry cell to open new Design Modeler. So our Design Modeler window is open. So select XY plane as a sketching plane and orient this sketch normal to the sketch view. For this, right click on XY plane and click on look at. Then sketch, click on this sketching tool mode, select line, then make sure that P, that means point constraint, appear before clicking. Then for the second point, it must be clear, or H constraint appear before clicking. So in this way we have created line. So specify dimension to the line. So select general dimension tool. So select line and give dimensions. So dimension of the line is 1000 as it is given in the, so zoom out for the fit to screen view. So here we have created the line. Then we have to convert this line into the line body. For this, click on this iso ball, then it orient the your view as a isometric. Then click on this modeling mode. So to convert this line into line bodies, go to concept, then select lines from the sketches. Then here we have to select the sketch 1, or you can select the line from the graphics window. So select sketch 1 and apply and click on generate. So here one part, one body is created. So but we have not assigned any cross section to the line body yet. So for this we have to create cross section first. For this go to concept, click on this cross section and click on channel section, because our cross section is C section, that's why click on this channel section. So here all the dimensions of section C section is given. So edit this in a detail view. So width is 30, again 30, then height is 50, the thickness is uniform, that is 4 mm. Right. So in this way we have given all the dimensions for the C section. Then we have to assign this C section to the line body. So click on line body, then the yellow color indicate that we have not assigned any cross section to the line body. That's why click on this cross section selection box, then click on this down arrow and select channel 1. So and click on generate. So in this way we have assigned the cross section, C cross section to the line body. If you want to see the cross section, then go to the view and click on display solid sections. So you will find the your C section line body. So here again go to view and click on this frozen body transparency. So So it will up the frozen body transparency. And also click on this display plane tab to make it off. The orientation of this C channel is horizontal. To make it vertical, click on this A selector, select line body, then retrace of the line body edge will be displayed in the retrace view, and change rotate angle 0 to 90. So it will orient your C section vertically. So in this way we have created the C, in this way we have created the C cross section line body for the beam. So you can save it and exit the design modeler. Next problem is we have to create thick plate of 5 mm thickness. Then how to pattern, we have to pattern the whole feature. First of all we have to create one hole, then we have to pattern the whole feature. That means we have to create the another 3 hole. Then how to create surface on split face and how to split the faces. So these are the 4 things we have to perform in the problem number 2. So for this first we have to create the circle. So for this close this design modeler for the first problem. Then again we have to create another geometry component system in project schematic and open design modeler. So here select again XY plane, right click, select look at, then select sketching mode and select circle tool from the draw toolbox. Then select origin as a center point, make sure P constraint appears before clicking, then create circle. So dimension of this circle is 100 mm. So give the dimension by the default general dimension. So make the change here, necessary change, that is 100 mm. So we have created the circle of 100 mm diameter. So click on this ISO wall for the isometric view, then click on modeling mode and select extrude feature, and so it is asking geometry. So for geometry select sketch 1 and apply. Then here depth is 5 mm, enter and create. So in this way we have created the thick plate of 5 mm thickness. After this we have to create hole feature. For this we have to create a new plane by using this tool. So click on this tool, that is new plane. So we have to define the positions and orientation of this plane number 4. For this click on this type selection box and change it from plane to from face. Then select base face. For this select the front face of the plate and apply, then click on generate. So in this way we have created the new plane, that is plane number 4. And above, so under this plane number 4 we have to create new sketch. So click on this new sketch icon and new sketch will be introduced below the plane number 4. So click on this sketch number 4 and right click and look at, click on this sketching mode to draw the sketch. Here we have to create a circle, that is base feature for the hole. So select a circle tool from the draw toolbox and create in vertical axis. So give the dimensions or specify dimensions to this circle, that is equal to 10 mm diameter. So again click on the ISO ball for isometric view, click on modeling mode and select extrude command. Here it is asking for geometry, click on sketch number 2 and click on apply. Then there is another change in operation. Instead of add material we have to select cut material, then change extend type to fix to through all, then click on generate to generate the operation. So complete the operation, right? Then here we have created the one feature hole. Next is we have to pattern this hole. For this go to create and click on this pattern tool, and here pattern tool is added in tree outline. Here it is, we have to change pattern type linear to the circular, then geometry. For this geometry we have to select the inner surface of the hole. For this select face selector, click on this inner surface of the hole, then apply. Then for axis, click on this axis selection box, then click on XY plane for the pattern axis. So Z axis is your pattern axis, this will get selected. So click on generate, and we require 3 number of copies, so click on generate. So in this way we have created the holes, hole feature by using the pattern tool, right? So next is, we have to create surface body on this on the front face, right? So for this we have to create a new sketch on plane number 4. So click on plane number 4, add new sketch, and orient this sketch normal to the sketch view. Click on, for this click on look at, then click on sketching mode, select again circle tool from the draw toolbox, click on origin for center point, then click on anywhere to create a circle, then specify the dimensions. So your dimension is 50 mm diameter. In this way we have created the circle. So again click on this iso ball or the isometric view, then click on the modeling mode, and we have to create surface body. For that click on this concept and select surfaces from the sketches. So here this is asking for a base object. So this is nothing but your sketch number 3, and click on apply, click on generate. So in this way we have created the surface body. So here you can find the solid body, and then here is a surface body. So sometimes we required number of regions. For this case we have to create a surface body on the solid. So again we can split faces. So for this go to tools, click on face split. So for this face split we have to select two things, that is target face and second is tool geometry. So for target face, select the front face of the solid plate and apply. Next is tool geometry. For tool geometry we have to select the edge. For this select edge selector and select edge, click on apply, click on generate. So select face selector, you can see the splitted faces on the front face of the solid model. So in this way we can split the faces. For sometimes we have to apply a boundary condition, force condition on the particular region, that's why we have to create these faces or surfaces. So this way we can create the surface body and we can split the faces. So this is all about the thick plate pattern of whole feature, surface on solid plate, faces, and how to split the faces. Thank you for the watching.